Hi guys, it's Carissa here, and today I'm going to do another tutorial for you on how to make a quick Disney-themed Bitmoji classroom. I'm going to share my screen now, and right here I have a document that I have created and will be sharing in Bitmoji Craze for Educators group on Facebook. I'm one of the moderators there, and as you can see, there are several slides. I'm going to go through those and show you what I have here for you to use in hopes that it will help you create a fun classroom that you truly love. Thank you. All right, I have several different coffee cups and a little wine glass there too that is Disney related. This one says, my students are 100 days smarter. This one says, thank you for teaching me. This one says, I'm done adulting, take me to Disney. I have felt like that many times. And this one says, I run on Disney and caffeine. And then, of course, here is the perfect little classroom coffee maker that you can put up high on a shelf where the students can't reach and always have a little cup of Joe to go. Here are some lamps and clocks. Here's some decor that you can hang from the ceiling of your classroom. A little welcome sign, two different Disney rugs, and a new little Disney Echo that I guess they've just come out with. Here is a slide full of all kinds of Disney theme chairs and pillows. The polka dots, the red and black things with polka dots on them, to me always remind me of Disney. So I found several there for you. They are all transparent images, so they're easy to use in your classroom that you're creating. And then here are various Disney classroom signs. Right here's the banner. When you use the banners, you usually just make a copy and then paste another one, and you connect them like that until you have whatever surface it is that you need covering done with the banners. Now I'm just going to leave that there because I know people will like it, and go on to the next one. Here's some classroom furniture and a little classroom pet. Also some other items for the classroom, a pen for the teacher, folder, and of course we got to keep those germs away. A few of these things have Safe Share links attached to them where you can embed that into what you're doing. Not all of the items, but there are several.
And the beanstalk.
Okay, I'm going to close that down though. As you can see, some of them have it and some of them don't. Okay. And then right here are the accessories for your teacher Bitmoji. Sorry guys, I only did it for the girls this time. But you can see over here, there are many different Mickey ears, and I have dressed up three different versions of my Bitmoji to show you examples of what you can do with it. There are aprons, sunglasses, earrings and necklaces, purses, face mask, and of course, those ears. On this slide, these are links to Safe Share images again. They're actually stories that will be read aloud to your students when they follow that link. I showed you in the last slide how to add those linked objects, but I am going to show you again really quickly how to do that. So I'm going to go to YouTube. And find a Tinkerbell song. Let's see. Like this one. Watch all the flowers. So I'm gonna copy that link. And then I am gonna go over here and type in YouTube Safe Share. You can tell it's a place I go often because it automatically populated. And here I'm going to paste that song that I just found. It has populated. You can see it now. And I have made the copy. Now I'm going to go back over here, and right here, this little Tinkerbell, I'm going to highlight her, and then I'm going to go up here to the insert link. When I click that, this little option comes, and I'm going to paste that in there and hit apply. Now, I want to animate her, and I want her to fly in from the left. On click, and I want her to do that slowly, so I'm going to slow that down. And I want to play that animation. So let's check this out. Aw, there's Tinkerbell. Okay. And we already have that song going, so I'm not going to play it again for you guys. But there we go. And then this last slide, I just thought you might enjoy. It has a Disney background and a rather large Disney head. I am going to go ahead, and on this one, I'm going to insert a new slide. I want to change the background. And I am going to look for, not Disney anymore, but a floor wall background. Okay, now let's see. I think for my classroom today that I like this one. I'm going to insert it. Ta-da, there is that. Now on this slide, I have this rug. I'm going to copy, and I'm gonna go down here, and I'm gonna paste it in really quickly, just a little bit of formatting change. And then on this slide, I think I like this girl the most. So I am going to select that so that everything that is highlighted gets copied and is pasted all together, layered perfectly and sized perfectly. So I'm going to hit copy, and then I'm going to go down here to my new classroom and hit paste. And there I am with all of my outfit that I've already created. I'm going to get this little item and put it in there. Let's see, where should he go? Think about there. And I like that bulletin board. Let's see, I'm gonna put this over here, I think. It's okay if it's going off the edge a little bit. I'm a bit of a perfectionist, so I when I do that, I like to line it up to the edge, just so it looks intentional that I placed it there. And I want that rug to go over a little bit because I don't want it to look like the furniture is sitting on that rug. Now I am going to paste my bulletin board. And I think I need it to be a little bit bigger for this classroom. Awesome. I am going to order it and send it backwards. Actually, I'm going to order and send it to the back because you could see how it layers behind me. Okay, now let me see what else I would like to add into this. I think I want to get these chairs. So I'm going to grab them, put them in, and just paste. It's just copy and paste. So I want to make sure that those are looking right for my perspective for the classroom. And now I want more of those chairs, so I'm going to copy and paste, and then I'm going to rotate those by flipping it horizontally in the other direction. Now I'll put them over there, and it's like I have a little bit of a circle time going on, which is perfect. Okay, what else do I need in my classroom? I think I need a little Mickey Mouse clock. That one has something attached to it. And I'm gonna put that over here on the wall. Perfect, I like how that's looking. And I do think I might want to make this bigger still. And then I am just going to try to line that up. Now, I do like to have a little bit of fun in my classroom, so I am going, oops, wrong thing. I'm going to add these to my ceiling. And those are obviously very much in the way. And I need to send them back. So I'm going to use the order button and send it backwards. I may have to do this a couple of times until it gets behind all the pieces. And sometimes I get a little tired of doing that. So if I, oops, I didn't grab my ears. If I grab all of these pieces again, there, they're all highlighted in blue, I can order this and bring it to the front. And now when I put this down, yes, those are hanging from the ceiling nicely and out of the way. But now I see I have messed up this order and need to send it backwards or just move it out of the way. Now I am going to tell it to go to the front. There we go. Easy peasy. And ta-da, I have a classroom. I do want to add a couple of more links to it. So I'm going to add these two, and I accidentally got three. That's okay. I'm just gonna copy it, put it in here, and I am gonna have those over here on the floor. And then I am just gonna erase that one. And now I want these to be the same size. So I'm gonna shrink them down a bit. There we go. And there I have a very cute Disney classroom. It took me less than 10 minutes to make. And I was able to use the items that are provided in this tutorial and document. This is all shared in the group Bitmoji Craze for Educators on Facebook. And I hope you guys have a great day. Bye.